Dear students, as soon as Walter Sutton presented his theory gained much recognition because it was somewhat consistent with the work of Gregor Mendel, and it was supporting some of its clauses as well. But the scientists, they had some reservations. Why those reservations arose? Because the theory has some flaws in it. What were the flaws? Now let us discuss. The problem with the theory was that it was supporting the work of Gregor Mendel. Some works of Gregor Mendel were supported by this theory. But if we go in depth of Mendel's work, we see that there were two laws presented by him that were very famous. One of them was the law of independent assortment. Mendel said that the genes that are located on chromosomes, they determine the characteristics, and when the chromosomes, they segregate during meiosis, the genes, they assort independently. Means there is no hard and fast rule that this gene will go in this cell and this gene will go in that cell, because as a result they are segregated independently. Means sometimes some gene will go in some cells, at the other time they will go in the other cells. But if there is independent assortment, then why the number of characteristics that are assorted independently, they exceed the number of chromosomes, the number of chromosomal pairs? Means we human beings, we have 23 pair of chromosomes, but the characteristics we possess that we say are controlled by the chromosomes or the genes, they are more than the number of genes. Are some genes controlling more than one characteristics? Why is the number of characteristics greater than or exceeds the number of chromosomal pair that are possessed by an individual? Means we can count the characteristics, the hair color, the skin color, the shape of the nails, the hair texture, curly, straight, means all this. And every character has some more features. Means there are a lot of eye colors. They can be gray, blue, green, brown, black. There are a lot of hair colors, from blonde to black. There are a lot of hair colors. Shape of nails, the color of skin. You cannot imagine how many skin colors there are in the world. So if the genes, they are assorting independently, if a gene is controlling the skin, how you can say there are a lot of skin colors? Means there are only two genes that are controlling the skin color, then why there are more than two skin colors? So these questions, the problems, I'll write it for your convenience, that if according to Mendel, the genes that are controlling certain characteristics, they are assorted independently, if this is true, then why the number of characteristics exceeds the number of chromosomal pairs? So this point actually caused scientists to have the reservations about Sutton's theory, and they started to think that maybe this theory is not valid anymore. So now we will discuss how the chromosomal theory was proved right by another scientist. Because the scientists, they have an interrelationship of working together on the same point till they reach at a certain point on which all of them they are agreed upon, and then that point or that theory becomes the law. You are well aware of this process. So now let us discuss about the process of proving the chromosomal theory right.